because he's such a wonderful topic, because I don't know nothing before starting this one. I don't know anything regarding this helicopter or what it is or what at all. I just saw in the movies and people are discussing about the drones and all stuff. And yeah, after seeing this stuff, yeah, I got confidence that yeah, I can do something in this one. So that I got more motivation in this one and just started doing mathematical modeling of hexacopter. And my part is that I have to mathematically model the hexacopter and also design the control part for the hexacopter. And the theoretical and practical part will be taken care of my friend Mogesh, but I will take care of the simulation part for the designing of hexacopter. Okay. So what's the outline of this today's presentation? So I will start with my goals of what I need to do, and in the introduction, and how the mathematical model will go, and how I have the system control, and what are the results I got, and lastly a conclusion. Okay, so what are my goals for these 3 months is that, firstly, I just want to mathematically model my hexacopter using Newton-Euler equations. So what are these Newton-Euler equations? These equations will define the motion of translation and rotational motion of a rigid body through application of forces and torques. So those are the main basic equations which we use for designing this hexacopter. Not only for hexacopter, these will be defined for every multi-rotor. And also, yeah, how to design, I want to design simulate PID controller. There are a lot of controllers, but we just want to stick it for simple one, which is PID. And we want to design altitude and heading and position of hexacopter. So coming to introduction, yeah, you all know what are the multi-rotors. Those are the great attraction today, because many are trying to design them on their own, because they just want to send it to their friend's home and see what are they doing. And some want to use it for space navigation, and also what are they want? Those are just making for fun, and those are also useful for industries as well. So how they are classified? Depending on the number of rotors. We all know basically hedgehog. It is nothing but it is a two propeller and two rotor system. But what is multi-rotor? Depending on the number of rotors, it will be classified. So coming to tricopter, it consists of 3 rotors, quadcopter 4, and hexacopter 6, and octocopter 8. But how will they navigate? I mean, how will they go in the space? For helicopter, a man will be there who can control the helicopter. But for what about these ones? So they will use the GPS for outdoor navigation, and they will use the cameras and laser scanners for indoor navigation. So how about quadcopter, hexacopter, and octocopter? So what's the basic difference? So basically, most of them are designing only quadcopters, but no one is going for hexa and octa, because quad is very easy. So we want to go for hexa and be complex. So that's why you went to hexa. Maybe we can go for octa later. So coming to quad, yeah, it has 4 rotors, and coming to hexa, it has 6. So what's the advantage of hexa over quad? In hexa, we have 6 rotors. So if we fail even with 1 rotor, the hexa can be able to balance. But what about octa? So octa has 8 rotors. So even it got failed for two rotors as well, it can be able to move. But for hexa, it can balance only, it can't be able to move. For octa, if it is failed, it only lose its heading control, but it can able to move and stable. But for coming to quadra, if even 1 rotor fails, the multi-rotor will fall down. So that's the advantage of hexa and quad. And what about the control? How can you control? We used to see people are playing these quadcopters with all the something device in their hands. That is nothing but radio controller. And we can also control through flight controller by designing PID control as well, so that it can navigate on its own. So basically, we'll go to mathematical modeling, how we started. So basics of mathematical modeling, first we need to know what are the frames of reference. Basically, we all know there are 2 frames of reference. One is inertial frame, one is body frame. So inertial frame is a fixed frame. Suppose we assume that we are measuring motion of the hexacopter sitting here itself. So I assume this is the inertial frame, and the instantaneous frame will be body frame. So that will be created at the point where the motion is happening. That's the difference between inertial frame and body frame. So how about the orientation? So we told that XYZ positions will be controlled by head frame and body frame. This position and velocity can be seen. But what about these rotations? These rotations will be controlled by angular rotations. So what are the basic angles you know? Those are nothing but roll angle, pitch angle, yaw angle. So I can explain here. So basically, roll angle will be defined by rotation about x-axis. So how can we get the rotation about x-axis? Take the rotors 1, 2, 3, and 5, 4, 5, 6. So what happens? Think like this. So we want rotation about x-axis. So if we increase 1, 2, 3 speeds and decrease 4, 5, 6 speeds, so the rotation will be around x-axis. So how can we get rotation about y-axis then? See, this is the y-axis. So even so, 2 and 6 rotors will not contribute towards the rotation about y-axis because there is nothing to do with these rotations. Only these 4 rotors will contribute to the rotation of y-axis. So what we can do? We can increase the speeds of 1 and 6 and decrease the speeds of 3 and 4 so we get the rotation about y-axis. That is called pitch angle. And what about the yaw angle? So basically, these propellers will all rotate about the z-axis. So basically, that will provide the rotation about z-axis, but the rotation will be opposite to the torque provided by these rotors. So to balance, what we will do is that we will increase 1, 3, and 5, and decrease at the same time 2, 4, and 6. So in that way, we can balance the rotation about z-axis, and we can get the yaw angle. So we want to convert some state variables from body frame to inertial frame. So what is the logic? Logic is nothing but release rotation matrix. This will be useful as a tool for converting from body frame to inertial frame. Suppose you want to convert body frame velocity to inertial frame velocity. You can just multiply this matrix with UVW, which are nothing but the body frame velocities. Same with the every state variable as well. We can convert from body earth frame to body frame, body frame to earth frame. There is nothing but the inverse of the one matrix. So what are the basic equations of motion? I told you that we will be using Newton-Euler equations. So what are the Newton-Euler equations? This is basic equations which we can find in net, because this is nothing but, this will define the motion of a rigid body when both translation and rotation are acting on it. So if there are forces and torques acting on a body, the equations will be governed by this one. This is nothing but mass into acceleration plus omega into mvd given by force, and this inertia into and alpha, that is an omega into I omega u slash 2 torque. So those are the general equations which we know, but how can we use them in our tensor power equations? So you can see the vb is nothing but uvm, which are the linear velocity in body frame, and omega v is nothing but pqr, which are the angular velocity in body frame. The force and the torque are the acting on the exocoupling body frame. So it looks like simple, but there is a lot of mathematics behind, which we can we can derive those equations from these two equations as well, because this VB is nothing but UVW and omega is nothing but PQR. So substituting these terms in these above equations, we can reduce these equations. This is just mathematics. So what are the forces and torques mainly acting on this sensor rocket? There are a lot of forces acting on this board, but what are the main forces we need to consider when designing the tensor rocket equation? The main forces acting are for gravity force and thrust force. We all know gravity force is the main force because it always try to pull down the hexagons, but we need to balance it. So what it is given by this equation. So actually, to convert from earth frame to body frame, we are using those rotation matrix, you can see there. And also the thrust force. The thrust force will be given by the 6 propellers. So it depends on the speeds of the 6 propellers, and it is nothing but this one, thrust force. These are the common forces which will be natural in any flight. And what about the torques? The torques will be provided by, which I said before, roll, pitch, and yaw. These torques will be provided by the rotors and gyroscopic torque. So these are the main forces of torques which we need to consider while designing. So this is the state space model which we sit for around 2 months and directed this model, because it's not easy. It might be simple here to look in equations, but it is very difficult to direct simply, because we did it just in the form of x dot equal to ax plus bu. So here x is the state variable which consists of all these 12 state variables, and u is the input vector which consists of thrust force and 3 torques. So that's it for mathematical modeling. Now just we will go to control. How can we control this exocoupling? Yeah, coming to basic setup for the control system, we can see. So up to now, we designed this one. This is a math model. And what about the controllers? So how to design the controllers? We need to design four controllers to control an exocoupler. They are basically attitude controller, which will control the z direction, and attitude controller, which will control the roll and pitch angles, and the heading controller, which will control the yaw angle, and this position controller, which will control the x angle. So which type of controllers can we use in those blocks? There are many types of controllers, like linear ones, there will be PID, and non-linear, it is lying mode controller, and it will be backstepping controller, and otherwise game shaping controller. So we want to be as simple as possible, so we choose PID controller. So you know, basically this is the equation which governs this PID controller. KP into E of T, KI into integral of E of tau, plus KD into V of E of PD. This is the basic equation which everyone knows. So how can we implement this controller to our hexacopter so that it will control the jet position, altitude, roll, pitch, and all the velocities? Okay. So KP, KI, and KD are the gains shown here. So coming to altitude controller. So how this altitude controller works? So it will take the, so you can see here, it will take the error value, calculating the jet and jet D. So basically we want to stick here by giving input from user side. That means we are giving the reference from user side, how much altitude you want, how much roll and pitch you want, and how much drag you want. So we are giving one vector which will tell the reference values for those controller. And it will compare the value with the actual value which is coming from the math model. So it will compare with the reference value, it will calculate the error. So how much altitude error is there? So that will be controlled by the PID controller. We can tune the gains according to it so that it will control and it will reach the steady state. So that is the U1, which is nothing but the control signal coming from the altitude. Suppose I gave a reference input of 5 units. Suppose I want my hexacopter to settle at 5 units. So let's see how it goes. So you can see here. My all the values are 0 except my z value. So it is lastly stabilizing a unit of 5. So even though it is getting some oscillations at initially, but at last it is settling at the reference point which we are giving, which is 5.
What is your time as
so that is settling at this value. Coming to heading controller, what is heading controller? So it is nothing but the control of yaw angle, heading controller. So it will take the reference from the input from the user side, which is 5D and side D, and it will take the actual value from the math model, and same process which we did for altitude controller, that's it. So like this, we will design all the four controllers, but the problem will be only at the position controller. See here, we are giving input of reference of 1 and it is replacing at the value of 1. So we tune according to it. So what about the position controller? You can see here, we are giving 4 inputs from only these 3 controllers. No input is coming from this position controller directly to map model. So what happens is that the attribute controller is indirectly controlled by this position controller, because the roll and pitch angles which given from user side will be decided by this position controller. So there are equations which can be linked up to position controller and roll and pitch reference angles. So see this, roll and pitch and reference angles are coming from the position controller, and these will go as reference to the actual values, and they will calculate the error, and the attitude controller will control that values. So we can see that is the position controller. But what actually position controller do is that it will control the x and y positions. So it will give the accelerations, and so it will stabilize the value at which we give. So we can give, say that we are giving the x reference and y reference at 5, and those are stabilizing at 5, you can see, and remaining all are stabilizing at 0. So this is only when we are having the effect of only one controller. I mean, what is the effect of z, what is the effect of roll controller, what is the effect of any controller. So what happens if all the controllers are combined? So let's go to the last controller, which is attitude controller, the same thing which we did for before, and the two input signals U2 and U3 will come from this attitude controller and go to the math model. So these two are the equations which will be coupling with position controller and attitude controller. From this you can see that this XD and YD will be coming from the position controller, and this YD and PID will give us input to the attitude controller. So from these equations we can couple, and we can use these equations to send the input reference input for the yaw and roll and pitch. So what happens if we control, before designing controllers, we just want to check whether our system is stable or not. So we just gave a step response of 5 units of altitude, and we want to see how it is responding. So whether the system is acting to our response or not. So when we give a step response of only F thrust, so only the Z direction should vary and remaining should stable at zero value. So that is the one we want to check, and we give a step response of 5 units, and what happens you can see here. The thing is the remaining order zero, only the Z direction is falling down. It is because, can you tell anything, anyone? Why the Z direction is falling? Yeah, it's because of gravity. I told you, gravity can act as single. It will always try to pull down our heads of our head. But what happens is that the gravity force is dominant than our force. So even we are giving 5 units of force, but the gravity force is dominating that effect, and it is trying to pull down the heads of our head. So what about the velocity of Z direction? You can see that from 500, we are giving the step input of 5 units. So you can see the difference. It is going to the, it is changing and going to the other value. So this is the step response. So we, from this we can say that yeah, our system is stable and accurate. And further, for we want to clarify it further, so we gave impulse response as well and see what it is doing. So we gave impulse response of 100 units at some time step, and how C can answer the difference here. At this time step, it is going to the peak and again it is stabilizing to the normal value. So what happens if we combine all the controllers, heading, yaw, and all the controllers? We can see that I gave a reference input of 1, 1, 1, which is nothing but I want my X-O-Oper to be stabilized at X position 1, Y position 1, and Z position 1. See that, you can see that. So Y, Z is stabilizing at 1, Y is stabilizing at 1, X is stabilizing at 1, remaining are stabilizing at 0. So what if I want to change my roller pitch angle and yaw angle as well? Suppose I gave a only x direction as 0, y z as 1, 1, and my yaw angle to be 1. So you can see that my only y and z are stabilizing at 1, and also the yaw angle is stabilizing at 1. Remaining all are stabilizing at 0. So that's the thing, and I want to conclude this presentation. And yeah, we developed mathematical model which is correct and accurate, because which can be proved from the step and impulse response. Yeah, our Hexacopter is able to control its orientation, position, and velocity, taking input from all the controllers. And also, the PID gates were finely tuned so that they will reach the steady state in less time. What is the future scope? Yeah, because we are giving user data.